Hey parents, whether you've had a baby before or not, there are certain things you should be doing to prepare yourself for pregnancy. Growing a baby is a lot of work, and in this video, I'm going to give you my top tips for both mom and dad to help get your body ready for a happier, healthier, and easier road to pregnancy. I'm Bridget, a childbirth educator and a birth doula, and if you're new to this channel, make sure you subscribe and hit the little bell so you don't miss any future educational and empowering videos. The first thing you should be doing in preparation for pregnancy is exercising. Exercising helps you manage weight and regulates your hormones, two crucial factors when trying to get pregnant. Being either overweight or underweight can impact the ability to become pregnant or carry out a healthy pregnancy. So whether you're over or underweight, moderate exercise is important for your physical, hormonal, and your mental health. Healthy weight is especially important for women when trying to conceive, but being over or underweight can lower the quality of sperm in men too. So guys, you need to make sure that you are finding ways to consistently implement exercise into your routine as well. Some great ways for you, mama, to exercise while trying to conceive are walking, swimming, cycling, or yoga. Lifting really heavy weights or running very long distances for mama might cause more stress on the body. So if you're having a hard time conceiving, it might be something you'd want to talk to your doctor about, possibly putting a short hold on those specific activities. The second thing is to have a balanced diet. Your food is either your poison or your medicine, and it has a direct impact on your hormones, which can either help or hinder you on your journey to pregnancy. Focusing on lean proteins like chicken, turkey, or egg whites, healthy fats from avocados, coconut oil, fish, or grass-fed butter, and loads of colorful fruits and vegetables, especially dark leafy green vegetables, is going to help make sure that you are getting the right macronutrients to balance your body and enhance your hormones to help you have a healthy cycle and body at conception. On top of a very well-balanced diet, taking supplements are so beneficial, and some of the ones that are linked to increased fertility in women especially are zinc, selenium, folate, vitamins B6 and B12, vitamin D and C, iron, and DHA. Along with those ones, vitamin E is also really crucial for male fertility. Mamas, you should be taking a prenatal vitamin, and dads, you should be taking a multivitamin. And for both, I recommend Ritual. I took Ritual all throughout my pregnancy, and I take them postnatally too, and they are sponsoring this video, but I would never recommend something that I'm not fully behind. They have essential vitamins and minerals that many vitamins don't have in them, like folate instead of folic acid. They're easy to get down because they taste like lemon, and there are no fillers, colorants, or yucky additives. I love these vitamins, and you will too, so I've linked them down below, and you can get 10% off your first 3 months by using the code BRIDGET10. The fourth thing to begin doing to prepare for pregnancy is tracking your cycle. Knowing when you start your period is going to help you understand when you are most likely to get pregnant. Everyone's cycle is a little different, so it's important that you start getting to know your own. There are apps like Flow or Clue that you can use to track your cycle that can give you an estimate on when you're ovulating, but one of the best ways to determine ovulation is by your discharge. When you're ovulating, you'll likely have discharge that is the consistency of egg whites, and this is when you are most fertile. However, if your periods are irregular and it's hard to track your ovulation and menstruation, it's a good idea to talk to your care provider about how to help with this process to encourage pregnancy. Your period gives you a lot of insight into your overall health. So if you're having irregular periods, having really painful periods, or they're very heavy, it might be worth having a specialist take a look at your hormones and what's happening on the inside. The final thing you want to do when preparing for pregnancy is to eliminate unnecessary stress and find healthy ways to manage it. Even if you're exercising, eating the right foods, taking the right supplements, and tracking your cycle, high amounts of stress can keep you from benefiting from those tips to get pregnant. Stress is more than just a feeling. It creates a physical response in the body called inflammation. Chronic inflammation in the body can lead to insulin resistance, which can negatively affect fertility. Consistent exercise and a diet rich in omega-3s like fish, antioxidants like in berries, oranges, carrots, and dark green vegetables, and spices such as turmeric, garlic, and ginger can help lower inflammation. However, reducing stress might also mean changing things with work, work or at home, or implementing purposeful stress relief into your routine like meditation, massage, talk therapy, or acupuncture. The journey to pregnancy can be stressful in and of itself, so finding ways to manage that through figuring out what is causing stress, communicating with your partner and loved ones, and getting a supportive care provider is going to help reduce a lot of stress along the way. Once you get pregnant, preparing for birth and postpartum are your next big steps. Whether you've given birth before or not, if you're finding yourself afraid or uncertain about labor, birth, and life with a newborn, you need to take the Build to Birth course that gives you the foundational building blocks for a happier, healthier, and easier birth and postpartum period. And if you're not quite ready to commit to the full course, you can always take the totally free mini birth class to learn my top 5 tips for an empowering and positive birth and postpartum experience. So thanks for being with me in this video, and I will see you in the next one.